Good morning, everyone. So sorry about that. My cat decided to hop up and knocked everything over. So give me one second here to recover from that. Timing is everything, right? He was sound asleep 2 seconds ago. Anyway, good morning. Happy Tuesday. Happy retired sale day, right? Yesterday we had our eclipse day. Today we have the retired product sale day. So, hey, if you are on, give me a shout out. Let me know that you're here. I'll give you just a minute to find me because I did hop on just a second or two before 10 o'clock. But yes, if you are, hey, hi, Sharon, good morning. Today, we launched a retired sale. So make sure that if there are things on our retiring list that are going away forever, and I put forever in quotes because sometimes they do reappear. And I have an example of one of those things for you today. Make sure you order and order early because I know a lot of folks on the East Coast who are up at 2 a.m. putting orders in. So I haven't checked recently what sold out, but I know there was already products that had sold out. So don't miss out on something you want. Get that order placed early. All right. So these are the projects that we did together the last time we were together. I love this product suite. And I am giving these cards away. All you need to do to be entered into the drawing for the cards that I create is to leave me a comment, give me a thumbs up, or subscribe to my channel. And the winner of these is Sharon Rowland. So congratulations, Sharon. Hey Judy, well, thank you for watching from Canada. Awesome. So Sharon, I will get these popped into the mail for you. I think my friend's coming over tomorrow to work in the studio, so I'm gonna have her do a bunch of mailings for me. But congratulations and thanks so much. All right, and then I wanted just to share with you this month's Just Cards. And they look a little like this. And if you are in the US, you are eligible to earn these card kits for free with a minimum $35 product order on my website using the monthly host code. Every month there is a new set of Just Cards. This happens to be this month's host code. So with a minimum $35, you get it for free. If you're long distance, we ask for $4 to help with the postage. But you can also come to the in-person class, which this time will be Tuesday, May 14th at 3 p.m. And if your order reaches $50, you're going to earn a free pack of embellishments, which I believe are the classic matte dots. And that was kind of tricky, knowing so many of our embellishments were retiring, so I had to stock up on those. But anyway, that is the Just Cards for this month. And yeah, that's how you get them for free. You can also purchase the class outright for $15, and again, with the postage. The other thing is, if you are around the area of Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, or want to come to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, and you love crops, I have a one-day crop happening on May 18th. That's a Saturday at Cozy Craft Nest, which is my new venture, my retreat house for crafters. It's an Airbnb, but it was designed for crafters. And the cost is $85, but you're going to get over $30 in product in there. You're going to get lunch. You have coffee, tea, water all day long, afternoon snack, some make and takes. I think there's three make and takes planned. So if you're interested in that, just leave me a comment or reach out to me. Again, it is Saturday, the 18th of May, and it is in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. And it runs from 9 to 9. Okay. Hey, let's talk about what we're all doing here, right? So the new catalog is just a couple of weeks from releasing now, and I have to tell you, I'm excited about it. The more I go through it, the more excited I get. So it is definitely a change from what we're used to. Another demonstrator said it was kind of like we've shopped in a grocery store for so long, and now we're shopping in a boutique, and there's helpful information in there, and there's card sketches in there, and it's going to be a lot of fun. But one of the fabulous things that's in there is the brand new 2024 to 2026 in colors. that look a little like this or exactly like this, right? Hey, Corinne, thank you. I don't know about you, but when I look at these, I just see a bowl of sherbet. That's the first thing I said to my husband when I got a peek at him. We have petunia pop. We have shy shamrock, peach pie, and summer splash. I'm testing myself. Hey, Carol, good morning. Good to see you. And then what I was saying earlier about sometimes we don't say forever when things retire, pretty in pink. And if you've been around as long as I have with Stamping Up, you know that pretty in pink used to be one of our core colors. So it is returning as an in color for 24-26. So if you happen to have any of those products, cardstock, marker, et cetera, ink pad sitting around, you might want to pull it out and check it out. My mom had some pretty in pink cardstock, which I was down at the retreat house working one day, and I'm like, oh, I went to look, and sure enough, she did. So I pulled it, and I'm anxious to compare it to the cardstock that's in the catalog now to see if we're going to be a perfect match or at least close enough to say, oh, it was a lot variation, right? But as part of In Color, every year I do an In Color club, and this year is no exception. Sorry, my voice is all funky there. So for instance, each month for five months, you are going to get six products in your featured color of the month. So let's say it's summer splash. You're going to get a full pack of cardstock. You're going to get the 6x6 designer series paper. Okay. So that's eight sheets of designer series paper in your color. You're going to get the Stampin' Blends. You're going to get the ink pad. And what the heck am I missing? Because that's only four. Oh, well, what's the other one? Ink pad, the ink refill, which I don't have. Oh, and the roll of ribbon, which I was demonstrating somewhere else, right? So you're going to get that, the re-inker as well. But unfortunately, that wasn't available to us in pre-order. You're going to get that whole package for $58 if you're local to me. If you're long distance, we are asking for, I believe it's $9 postage. To mail the kits to you. And we can talk about that if you want me to hold and do like every other month mailing. We could do that and save you a little bit of postage because, you know, two of the months would fit into a priority box for sure. In the third month, you are going to receive as a little bonus the resin dots in the new in colors. Don't they look yummy too, right? And then in the fifth month, as my thank you to you for being part of my In Color Club, you are going to receive the shimmer embellishments. These are the shimmer gems in all those yummy new In Colors, which are so pretty. I love shimmer gems. And you're going to get a 6x6 sampling of the glitter paper. So just a little sampling, a 6x6 sheet of each one of these beautiful new glimmer papers. And that's just going to be my little thank you that comes with your final kit. So if you are interested in that, I put the link below. So you can go ahead and click on that and read more about it or get registered. Registration will close at the end of the month because I'll be ordering all the goodies as soon as it launches. The new catalog launches so that I'm sure to get everything for everybody. But we'd love to have you as part of the In Color Club. And there might be a surprise or two scattered amongst the other months as well. You just never know with me. I'm tricky like that. But I'm going to bring in the rest of the cardstock so you can see. Maybe that's a little better than the... I don't know which one's my favorite yet. I'm thinking it's going to be Petunia Pop because it's the purple. But I love the peach pie. And I'm telling you, this pretty much looks like pretty in pink as I remember it. So I'm anxious to compare the two. All right. So there we go. So that's all the new in colors. They're yummy. I can't wait to play with them. I'm on the race now to get to the end of the month because we leave for Mexico. And that's kind of making me hyperventilate a little bit because I have a lot to do between now and then. So I'm going to walk you through some of the other products that I got. Another upcoming product line, if you will, that I'm really excited about is the ephemera packs. So this is the Sunny Springs cards and envelopes. And we're just going to pull them out. You can see what the envelopes look like. So pretty. And then this is the combination. They're plain on the inside that you get in that pack. Okay. And then you get several sheets of a variety of ephemera packs. And I think there's at least one, we'll just pull that too. There's at least one, two. And then another two. This is the labels. So there's four different sheets, two of each. So there's lots and lots of goodies in here to play with. These are going to be great not only for card making, guys, but for scrapbooking, right? I think these would make cute little accents and embellishments in your scrapbooks as well. This pack is called Labels and Layers Ephemera Pack. And then we also have, which actually probably goes with more with the Calming Creek. But look, this is kind of cool background patterns. Probably, maybe not this one necessarily, but those four would be great for making mass healing cards with those labels. And then here's another one of the ephemera packs. This is the fully flowering ephemera pack. So I am actually going to use these at my team meeting and let them design. Here's a sneak peek if any of my team members are on. You're going to get to design with these yourselves. So it won't be a structured make and take, but you'll get to play with some of these goodies. So I really think this is going to be cool. I'm planning on offering an actual class with these, where everybody will get their choice and then come and create projects. But that is a new selection of goodies that we're going to be having. And I think that's a really cool idea. And especially if you're beginning in stamping and you're not sure, or maybe you're older, you don't have a lot of space. This with the Simply Said stamp set, and you can make a lot of different cards, right? So great for people that maybe are in a retirement home and don't have a lot of space, their hands shake and they don't want to do a lot of stamping. Great for younger stampers. If you have kiddos or grandkids or nieces or nephews that like to stamp with you, I think this is going to be a great option for all of those things. Hey, Debbie. Yeah, I know. We're going to be in the 70s here. Good morning, Carol. Happy belated birthday, Carol Deegan. All right. So let me show you two new embossing folders, and let me show you the size of these embossing folders. So this is so swirly embossing folder. Look at this. I missed it. When we were ordering, I missed that these were going to be the larger size embossing folders. But again, another great opportunity. Maybe you can cut one or cut two pieces and put them in here and emboss it one time if you're making multiples of a project. Great for background mats on scrapbooking, all that kind of different ways to use the product. So that is the So Swirly. And then this is the dotted circle, which is kind of cool, I think. Almost reminds me a little bit of a labyrinth, although the circles do not connect as they go through there. But again, nice big one. This one is a 3D, so it is much thicker than the So Swirly. The So Swirly is a standard embossing folder, and you'll make the same sandwiches. So just because it's a little bit bigger, does not matter. You'll still make the same sandwich to get it through your embossing machine. Corinne's got rain. Yeah, we had rain a lot last week. I'm hoping. Well, it's supposed to come back, so we may never mow. Rick was mowing in the dark last night. Thank God he has a headlight on his mower. So I'm kind of showing you like the individual products that I got, and then I'm going to show you a couple bundles here. This is loveliest a tree. Loveliest tree. Oh, see, I said the old words. Oh, I'm so glad you had a good day. We had a set called Lovely as a Tree years ago, and I can remember Shelly sharing with us at one of our events that it was created, I believe it was in honor of an aunt, and that it would never retire. And I remember the year it retired, and we were all like, no, you can't take that away. And as soon as I saw this tree, it reminded me of that stamp set. So this one is Red Rubber. And then it has these cute little dies to go with it. We can make our own tree. We have the tree image to cut out. We have the leaf image to cut out, and then a few extra accent leaves as well. A lower price point for a bundle, which I know some of us have been saying, hey, we need some things in a little bit lower price point. So this bundle will be a little bit lower price point for you. You're for all of us. And then, you got to get some kiddos, right? Look how cute. Now, actually, I would use a couple of these for anniversary cards as well. But these are adorable. Hearts and Hugs is the name of the stamp set. And we've got sending birthday hugs, so it's there when you need it. I could just hug you, sending a big hug, and thanks are the words. And all those cute little animals, the mouse, the walrus. I'm not sure what these are. They're kind of striped up here, but not back here, so I don't think they're skunks. I don't know if he's a chipmunk or what, but he's awfully cute with those big fat cheeks. And of course, we have dies to cut all of those out. We also have a flower die that we can put together. We have a banner die, and then we have lots of different heart shapes. So that'll be fun. That will be fun to play with and color. And I love me those blends. All right, let's move into just a few more basics and then we'll get into the suites of products that I got. And actually, I meant to grab a stamp and a block. Let me do that real quick so I can show you. Any other time, Lori's got 1,000 stamps laying on her table. Not today. Not today. I'm gonna grab two because I don't really know. I haven't even played with it myself. I've been bumming around with a really badly sprained. I don't know if it's my thumb joint going into my wrist or if it's my wrist and it's hurting up through my thumb joint. So I haven't been doing a whole lot of stamping, but so I haven't even played with any of this, although it did just come in. So let's try the new. Basic beige. That was my wrist, not the fact that the ink pad was hard to open. So I'm going to do it on white. And I also brought a piece of black here. Okay. So that's what that looks like in basic beige. That's a good addition to our neutrals, I think. I like that. I don't know. Let's see if it shows up on the black. Not at all. It is definitely not a craft pad, so I didn't really expect it to, but I just wanted to play to make sure that my theory would be right. So it is just a regular classic ink pad, but it is a kind of a nice color. Has a little bit more of a green tint than I expected. Can you see that? Is it showing up on the camera for you? So there we go. So that's our basic beige. Here is the basic beige cardstock to go along with it. Anybody else see green in that? Or maybe it's just me. But I do think it'll be a good addition. I know very vanilla. We love the thick gray vanilla and all that. But it is a good addition, I think, to the neutrals and will go nicely. Again, like I really think that's going to be a great combo. And also with some of our like early espresso, maybe. Right. So that is our basic beige addition. And then we have the ribbon as well, the basic beige ribbon. And it has the stitching on both sides. And we have some textured metallic 12 by 12 shimmer or specialty paper. And I always hate to bring metallic papers in because I know you're going to get a glare. So I'm going to apologize in advance for that. But it definitely, and I'm trying to get it at an angle so the texture will show up for you. It looks like a linen weave to me. That could be me. And we have it in the three gold, silver, and copper. And that glare. I don't know if I can get it that you can see the texture on it. Probably not. It's just too much of a glare. But you can definitely see it in person. And that's kind of cool. And reality is that, I don't know about you, but with the shiny metallic, sometimes it gets damaged in transit or in my studio, it might get damaged. And man, the minute it gets a mark on it, you can see it. That's going to hide it very well if that happens. So less likely to have product that I have to get rid of. How does the beige compare to Sahara sand? I think it's got more pigment than Sahara sand did. Sahara sand was a little more tan than what the beige is. And I think it the beige stands out a little bit better, if that makes sense. All right, let's take a gander at Adventurous Sky. So I already know this suite is sold the minute it shows up because I have a girlfriend whose husband is a pilot. He's in the Navy, and now he is part of the Maryland State Police and flies the helicopters and has does and he's the lead for the engineering maintenance on the helicopters, et cetera. So, and Amy, if I misquoted what he does, I apologize. But anyway, I know anytime there's a plane around, Amy's going to be looking at it. So this is a really cute set. Lots of stamps in here. Great masculine set. Flying by to say hi. You're the best. Plain, Plane, and simple. You got a happy birthday. This looks like farmland from the sky. Lots of clouds. To my friend, you always lift me up. And happy Father's Day. With, of course, the coordinating dies. So that will be fun. We got our propellers over here and the biplane, and then of course all our dies to cut out our stamped images. And I think this is like a little banner type dice right there. There are also these really cool industrial. Don't know how much you use this joint until it really hurts. This is called industrial trinkets. So it's kind of looks like oh, I am horrible. Yeah, that's what it looks like. A bolt and nut. That's the words I'm looking for, a nut and bolt on this side. But you know what, guys? And I know it wouldn't necessarily be flat, so you definitely want to use a glue dot. I'm liking the backside too. It kind of looks like a starburst. So, either way, I think you could use it. I think the nut and bolt would be cute with the plane, but you can flip that thing over, put a glue dot on the back of it, and I mean, it'll definitely be raised off your paper. Be careful with your postage and your mailing, but it really has a very cool starburst effect on the backside too. And I don't know if that's showing up in camera or not. It's hard to see tiny things in the camera. Okay. They're going to be fun. And then the designer series paper, you know, we love our designer series paper. There's one with all the planes in the sky. And then just a really cool background pattern. Kind of looks like topography. Here's our clouds and a nice basic check. Great masculine colors again. And then one that you can cut down into smaller pieces. Got some tags on here. That's pretty cute. Yeah, I love this set too. This is going to be really popular. We need good masculine sets, and I think they hit it out of the park with that one. Now let's go from masculine to something a little more feminine. Thoughtful wishes. Okay. Nice stamp set. Great greetings, dearest friend. Thinking of you fondly. Thanks. Missing you. You make life better, and I appreciate you, are the greetings. And then you have the images. Red rubber. Look at the dies. These are fabulous. Of course, everything to cut out all of our stamped images, and then all these extra standalone dies, like I like to call them, will be great fun. Definitely an opportunity to use your adhesive sheets on the back of your cardstock before you run it through your die cutting machine, because this would be a challenge to get Tombow liquid glue on, I think, or even fine tip glue. But yeah, I think those will be a lot of fun. And you can do standalone imagery on your cards. You don't even have to stamp. So again, if you have folks that are newer and aren't necessarily wanting to do a whole lot of stamping, this is going to be a great set to assist with that. This also has the adhesive backed pearl trio in there. Let's open it so we can see the top ones. Okay, and I did not write down what colors these were, but they're pretty. They're very pretty. And then this is the 6x6 designer series paper. So this is the paper we're seeing everywhere, and everybody's going, "What is that? It's beautiful." Reminds you of Meandering Meadow, right? Designer series paper. Look at these colors. This is absolutely gorgeous. I love these papers, this style of paper. You can do so much with it. Just absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous designs. I didn't really look at anything like this closely. I pulled it all out to set it up, and then I'm looking at it with you for the first time. So lots of purples and blues and greens and the peach pies in there. Peacock. I love it. So let me tell you exactly what colors are in there. That has Blackberry Bliss, Boho Blue, Cajun Craze, Calypso Coral, Lost Lagoon, Misty Moonlight, Mossy Meadow, Pecan or Peach Pie, Petunia Pop, Pool Party, Pretty Peacock, and Wild Wheat. That will cover everybody, right? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. And maybe it's one of the purples. So maybe it is the Petunia Pop. I'm not 100% sure. And then one other product in that is the Thoughtful Designs specialty paper. For some reason, I did not pull this out ahead of time. So we've got some shimmer and shine in a plant pattern, and they're just plain white on the back. Pretty in pink. I'm wondering if this is the in colors. So there they are. Let's see. Does it tell me? It does. So we have Cajun Craze, Calypso Coral, okay, Lost Lagoon, Misty Moonlight, Mossy Meadow, Petunia Pop, Pretty Peacock, and Wild Wheat. All right. I don't see what they see. Unless they're saying it would co coordinate with the. Oh, wait. Now. Okay, that's interesting. It is five sheets, but maybe they're saying that's what all it will coordinate with. Because I definitely see Pretty Peacock, Wild Wheat, Cajun Craze. I'm not really seeing Misty Moonlight, Petunia Pop. Yeah, or Lost Lagoon. But it's pretty regardless, right? It has a sheen to it. And those real pretty colors. So that is that Thoughtful Expressions product line. Have to roll over here a little bit further to grab the next one. This is a big one. And this one, as soon as I saw the catalog, I knew it was going to be on my first order. It kind of takes me back to when I joined, and I joined in the early 2000s. But the Country Birdhouse, how cute is this set? And I can see figuring out a way to make that birdhouse 3D pretty easily. And then here are the coordinating dies. So multi-layer roofs, the bow string to hang it from, some standalone floral images, and then everything to cut out all of our stamped designs. Okay. That is part of the suite of products that also includes the country floral or flowers. Well, I thought it looked ombre, but yes. And when I take it out of the direct light that's under my camera, it absolutely is ombre. Here, yes, you can see it on the purple, I think, right? Deeper to the petunia pop. So, yeah, you're right, Carol. That's exactly what it is. And sometimes those lighter colors, like the calypso, to me, I'm having a hard time seeing it on that, but that's just my eyesight. So, very good. Good catch. Good catch. Okay. So, country flowers dies look like this. Again, lots of things to cut out, and then additional bonus. I call them bonus dies, right? So cute. Now I just have to find the time to play with all my new toys, right? We've got some smoky slate pearl, which I love, two different sizes there, and two different shades of the smoky slate, a lighter and a darker. Actually, it's basic gray and smoky slate. Another embossing folder. This one is called Islet, and it is a 3D folder as well. But it is our normal, what we anticipate seeing when we think of embossing folders, right? Our normal size. And then we have this fabulous, we all love our wood grain paper, right? This is Country Woods. And let's look at the colors. This has basic beige, basic gray, crumb cake, early espresso, gray granite, misty moonlight, pecan pie, petal pink, pool party, smoky slate, and wild wheat in it. So all kinds of wood grains. This reminds me of my mother's coffee table. She had that light blonde. It was like a covering over the wood itself, but kind of reminds me of that. Oops, I pulled two of those apparently. Yeah, how'd I do that? Now that one's interesting. Like that one too. So that is the wood grain or the country wood. And then this is the country lace, and this is basic beige, misty moonlight, petal pink, and smoky slate. Very soft pattern on there, which I like that because this side is very feminine. This side could be masculine. Little bit of flower detail in there. Another great one. That looks like denim. I don't know if the camera's picking up these real subtle patterns. Nice basic gray. Because these are subtle, almost to the point that I can't see them. But that, again, that's me, not necessarily the general population would have that problem. There's a basic beige. Definitely see the green in that, right? Definitely see that. Nice. So, yeah, that whole suite of products is going to be very popular as well, I feel. Everybody seems to like that, especially the wood grains, right? We all love that. And then we have the the country style stamps with the birdhouse and the florals and all of that. All right, this is my last sweet. And some of it I already shared with you because the shimmer dots, shimmer gems for the in colors, and the glitter paper for the in colors is also part of this product line. I did not buy the other stamp set that was in this, but I did get the greeting set, Unbound Love. Lots and lots of greetings in here. Everything from happy birthday to faith is being sure of what we cannot see. Peace makes the world a better place. May all your wishes come true. My heart comes out to you, goes out to you. I can't read this morning. And hope is believing in brighter tomorrows, and then a whole bunch of other ones in there. But check out the die set. Hey, Donna, you did. Good job. Yeah, this one's gonna fly off the shelf because we all love these dies that we can cut out any greeting, whether it's part of this Unbound Love set or another set. And there's some really different ones in here. Like I love this one with the leafies in the corner, and then this cute little oval with stitching, scalloped oval with stitching. This one's really cute too. Another oval. We need ovals. I was really hoping we'd have an oval, like we have the deckled circles, the deckled rectangles. Couldn't we have a deckled oval? Didn't see that yet. But anyway, this is a great die set. It goes with the Unbound suite of products. The die set itself is also called Unbounded. I'm saying Unbound, it's Unbounded Love. So that will be a good one. And it also has beautiful. Crash. I knew eventually something was going to hit the floor. I had run out of stock or stacking room. Beautiful designer series paper. This paper is the Unbounded Beauty, and it has Berry Burst, Calypso Coral, Peach Pie, Petunia Pop, Pretty in Pink, Pretty Peacock, Shy Shamrock, and Summer Splash colors. So again, lots of the new in colors are incorporated into these patterns. If you like to fussy cut, I could see fussy cutting that pattern. That's Peach Pie. And that, I would guess, Coastal, Summer Splash and Shy Shamrock are going to be a challenge for me to see the difference between. If I see them side by side, I can tell, but standing alone, I'm not sure. That's a pretty one. All right, so that again is the Unbounded Beauty Designer Series paper. And then I did show you the shimmer and the shimmer dots that go with it. So that's what I got in my first order. Demonstrators have the opportunity to order from now until the end of the month and pre-order and get new products in so we can start creating and designing to share with everyone. If you are not a demonstrator and you want access to that product earlier, you can always consider joining. It's always a great time to join Stamping Up. You get $125 in free product for just $99 plus tax. And if you don't have someone that you're working with and you want more information about that, please reach out to me, or you can click on my joint link in the description below the video to see a little bit more about it. My team is the Stellar Stampers, and I have business builders as well as hobbyists all across the states. So we'd love to have you join us as well if you're looking for a Stampin' Up! Family to become part of. And that's what I have for you today, ladies and gentlemen. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget the sale on the retired product has started. This product will launch with the catalog at the beginning of May. So make sure you are building your wish list as your catalogs arrive so you're ready to roll when that launches. And in the meantime, make sure that you don't miss out on any of the retiring product that you want to have and be able to continue to use. I always recommend stocking up on your colors, right? I do believe most of the reinkers for the in colors are gone. I think cardstock and maybe some blends are still available, so you might want to check that out. But make sure you are taking advantage of those discounts. All right. Hey, thank you so much for watching. I'll be back over on my Facebook page on Sunday night at 8 for Sunday stamping. And I'll be back here next Tuesday with something fun to share with you. Until then, have a great week, be safe, and I'll see you soon. Thanks again. Bye.